We've often said that sea lamprey look like some sort of alien blood-sucking creatures from the deep. Okay, maybe that's just me. But it turns out a national TV show agrees.
River monsters on the Animal Planet featured Lake Champlain and the lamprey. News Channel 5's David Schneider joins us live in the newsroom with more on this on the Environmental Beat tonight. Hi there, David.
All right, well, if you're a fish, I suppose, a sea lamprey might be the thing of nightmares. They're the slimy, eel-like creatures that will attach and eat a hole in the side of a fish. But what about people? A recent episode of the show River Monsters featured a swimmer who encountered a sea lamprey in Lake Champlain. So we talked to the experts.
Sea lamprey looked the part of a monster, a parasite with a mouth designed to rasp a hole in a fish and suck out fluids.
Blood-sucking fish in Lake Champlain is a great hook to reel people in.
The television show River Monsters recently aired an episode on sea lamprey in Lake Champlain.
They then bore a hole by means of these teeth that they have inside, and then they drink the body fluid. They have been known to attack people, but in this particular place they're not in feeding mode.
So what exactly does attack mean when we're talking about lamprey and people?
They're not going to attack humans. They're not going to parasitize humans.
Jason Stockwell directs UVM's Rubenstein Lab on the shores of Lake Champlain.
Sea lamprey are very slow swimmers or very poor swimmers, and so they often attach to things that are moving in order to get from place A to place B. They could attach to a human, but our body temperature is wrong, our feel is wrong.
If a lamprey did attach to a human, he says it would not rasp a hole through the skin to feed. It would likely use suction to catch a ride, maybe. But he says even that is unlikely. Still, if a swimmer ever did pick up an unwanted hitchhiker, Stockwell says getting a lamprey to release is not all that difficult.
You pull them out of water, they'll be suffocating, they'll be stressed, they'll let go and want to get back in the water.
He says sea lamprey are not an issue for swimmers in Lake Champlain. Blue-green algae blooms that can produce toxins and sharp zebra mussel shells are much bigger concerns, according to Stockwell.
Now, he also says the real threat of sea lamprey are the harm they do to Lake Champlain's prized trout and salmon. State and federal fish and wildlife officials have been fighting lamprey for years, and they say they are seeing healthier game fish in the lake. Live in the newsroom, David Schneider, News Channel 5.